Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's class, we'll do this curve. This curve name is epitrichoid. Try to do this diagram by using the pencils in the drawing sheet. Okay, here for getting the clear view, I'm doing with other colors. In the last class, we did this inferior trichoid. Here, trichoid means it is also like cycloid. If you are taking P point instead of on the circumference, if you are taking inside the circle or outside the circle, like this, if you are taking inside the circle, you will get this P path like this. Okay, if you are taking outside the circle, P point, the path will come like this. Okay, so process is similar, but here we are taking P point instead of on the circle, we are taking inside the circle or outside the circle. Okay, in the last class, we did inferior trichoid also. So in this class, we will do epitrichoid. So it is also similar to epicycloid. Epicycloid means on the curved surface. So I have given one example also in that video. So this is the curved surface. On this curved surface, one circle is rolling and moving in this direction. Okay, I will show the example also. So this is the circle. So on the curved surface, this circle is rolling and then moving in this direction. Okay, like this. So here, if it is rolling on the curved surface, the path of this P point, P is on the circumference of the circuit. Let us take this is the P point. Now we have to mark all P points. Okay, after that here we have to mark. After that P point will be here. After that P point will be here. Okay, like that if you are marking all the P points for complete rotation, for complete revolution, so P point is coming here at the end. So from starting point to end point, one complete revolution of the circle on the curved surface. If you are joining all P points, we will get the curve like this. Okay, this is the path of P point. This path is called epicycloid. Okay, here in trichoid also, we are taking one point which is inside the circle, not on the circumference of the circle. If P point is inside the circle and the circle is rolling, okay, in this direction or on the curved path, then the P path will come like this. I did here roughly. So this curve is called inferior epitrichoid. If P point is outside the circle, the path will come like this. Okay, it is called superior epitrichoid. So let us take this inferior epitrichoid. So only one important difference between these two is, here P point is on the circumference, here P point is inside the circle. Okay, let us do this diagram. Let us take the given data for doing the inferior epitrichoid. A circle of diameter 50 mm rolls outside a circular arc of radius 90 mm. Here the rolling circle diameter is 5 cm or 50 mm. The same given data I have written here. Circle diameter is 50 mm. Radius is 25 mm. I am taking this is the example of circle. Okay. So let us take the circle diameter is 5 cm. Okay. And it is rolling on the arc of radius 90 mm for one revolution. Okay. This circle is rolling outside a circular arc. Just now I have shown this is a curved surface, it is a circular one on which circle is rolling. Let us take like this. Okay, like this. Now here the arc radius has given 90 mm. As I told, this is arc, this radius, it is 90 mm. So same thing I have written here. So this is a bigger curved surface, so it has bigger radius compared to this smaller radius, correct? So this is a smaller circle, this is a bigger circle. So for one revolution, so one revolution means this smaller circle is rolling on this bigger arc for one revolution. One revolution means, let us take here, I am taking one point. Let us assume like that. Okay, initial point. Okay, this is the starting. Here I have marked on the curved surface. Now for one revolution, let us take, it is moving like this slowly. Like this. Like this. Okay. Now again, it is starting point is coming here. Now here also mark one point. Okay, so from this mark to this mark, this smaller circle is making one revolution. Okay, so here also in the given question, it is making one revolution. Full stop. Draw the locus of point lying at a distance of 16 mm from the center of the circle. Here we need to take one point. I am taking that point is capital P. We can take any alphabet here. Okay, I am taking P point. So this P point is at a distance of 16 mm from the center of the circle. Okay, here for this circle, we need to take one point. From center to that point is 16 mm. Center to this point, how much it is? It is nothing but radius, correct? So diameter is 15, radius means half in it. Okay, it is 25 mm, but the given point is 16 mm from the center. So for marking it, I took this example. From center, I took 16 mm distance, one point. Let us assume like that. So here, observe one thing. We are not taking this P point on the circumference. Here we are taking the P point, okay, inside the circle, like this. Now here, this is the position of this diagram. Let us do practically. Let us assume, mark the center here initially. I will mark the circle also like this. I will draw the circle also like this. Okay, roughly I am doing here. We need to find the path of P point. This is the P point we are taking. Initially mark the P position. Let us assume here I am marking P like this. Now it is moving like this. Okay, mark the P position. So this P position is coming here. Now again it is moving because it is making one complete revolution. Now P position is here like this. Now it is moving like this. P position is here. So P position is here. P position is here. P position is here. So just do a rough circle here. This is the end point. Now this is the circle roughly I did. So this point, initial point, it is here. Now it is coming at the end here for one complete revolution. Okay. So we did the P path position. Okay, all these P points. Now I did the circles roughly. You did this curve also, okay, for one complete revolution or rotation. So from this starting point to end point, I did the curve also, bigger arc. So this arc radius has also given 90 mm in the question. Okay, if you join all the P points, this is the initial point, P point. Okay, if you join all this P position like this, so the diagram is coming like this. So for doing this curve, so roughly I will do here. This is the smaller circle. Okay, it is moving on a curved surface like this. Okay, so from this initial point to end point for one complete revolution like this. For doing it, the given data is, this diameter has given and this radius, arc radius has given, how much it is? 90 mm. Okay, radius means from this point to this point, 90 mm. Okay, this radius, capital R. And here small r is, what is the radius of it? Diameter is 50 means radius is 25 mm. Okay, here by using these two values, we can find this angle. Okay, let us take this is theta. We have one formula. Theta is equal to 360 into small r by capital R. So here 360 into small r means radius of the smaller circle. How much it is? 25 divided by capital R means 90. These two values have given in the question. Okay, find out this angle by using the calc. So 360 into 25 divided by 90. So this angle is 100. Okay, so here take down this angle is 100 degrees. Let us do this diagram by using the drawing instruments. Initially take any one of the point as center. Okay, take 9 cm, do an arc. Let us do here. Use some gap here for the diagram. Okay, here take one point. I am taking that center is O. O as center. Take radius is 9 cm by using compass. 9 cm radius. Do an arc. After getting the arc, take any one of the point. Okay, I am giving the name capital A. Join this point to center. Just extend the line here. Okay. Now here on this curved surface, we have to take 100 degrees. Okay, this 100 degrees we had to mark. By using the protractor, take at the center this point. Keep this line coincide with the initial line. Okay. Now from here, take 100 degrees up to here 90. Next, here 100 degrees. Okay. Join this point to center and extend the line. degree, this angle is 100 degrees. Keep the arrows at both sides. Now after getting this arc length, give this last point, it will be here I am giving. And this is the starting point A, this is the end point B. So AB is the arc length. Okay. After getting this arc, now extend this line and take 2.5 cm, mark this center C. Okay, on this line. Here keep the scale. Now here we will get smaller circle, correct? What is the diameter? 5 cm. Okay. What is the radius? 2.5. From 5 to 2.5 here, this is the center. This length is 2.5 cm. So I am taking, this is the center of the smaller circle. Okay. Now by using compass, do the smaller circle. Take this length. Just do a circle here. After getting the circle, just extend this line. It is the diameter of the smaller circle. Okay, this is the AB path. This is the smaller circle. C is the center of the smaller circle. After that, mark the P point in this circle. So how much distance P point is from the center? It is 16 mm. It has given in the question. Okay, point capital P is 16 mm distance from the center of the circle. So by using scale, so from this center, you better to take on the diameter, okay, P point. So 16 mm, this is 15, next, this is 16. Now what is the name of the point we are giving? Capital P. Okay, this is the initial point. Now here, take CP length, that is 16 mm or 1.6 cm. Just do one circle here by using compass, okay. Make one more circle. Here we got the smaller circle. Divide this smaller circle into 12 parts. We can divide into any number of parts, 6 parts or 8 parts. It is our wish. Now here I am dividing this smaller circle into 12 parts. For dividing it, at the center, what is the angle of the circle? 360 degrees. Okay. So 360 degrees, we are dividing into how many parts? 12 parts. 12, 3, 36, 30 degrees. Each part is 30 degrees. Okay. Here, so divide, take 30 degrees here. Okay, first part, second part, third part, like that. So by using the protractor, we can mark the angles. So this is coincide with the diameter. Okay, so take from here, reference line, 30 degrees. Okay, here 30, first part, next 30, 30 plus 30 means 60, at 60, one part. Okay, again 60 plus 30 means 90, 90 plus 30 means 120. Okay, at 120, 120 plus 30 means 150. Okay, here we got all the points. So join these points to the center within the smaller circle. So this is the first point. Now in this direction, within the circle, I will do the one line. I will extend this side of the circle also, because circle is symmetrical. Now after this, take the next point, join this point to center. Do the line within the circle. Now next point is this point. Now after that, next point is here. Now next point is here. Now here we have divided this smaller circle into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 equal divisions. Okay, after that, we have to give the names for it. Starting point is P. Okay. So here give, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this point is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Here this is a P point, P comma 12. Okay, after 11, 12, 1. Now here, after that, here we have to do the center arc, because here this circle is rolling on this curved surface like this. Okay. Now center is also moving from this position to this position. Again center is coming here. Again center is coming here. So we have to do the center arc also. Okay, how much this distance? Same as radius. Okay, take this as a radius. Just do an arc up to this last extended line for marking the centers. Extend this line like this. Okay, up to some length. Now by using the compass, take O as center. OC as radius. Okay, so do an arc here because on it centers are coming. Initially C is the center, next C1, C2, C3 like that when the circle is rotating. Okay, now here how many centers are coming? Here we are taking 12 divisions, so 12 centers are coming here. For marking those centers, so we have divided this 100 degrees into 12 parts. Each part angle is 8.3 degrees. Okay, 8 degrees we can mark. How to mark 8 degrees? If you are taking 0 to 10, so after 5, 6, 7, 8. So exactly we can mark. 8.3 we can't do. Okay, that's why what I am taking. First I am taking 8 point some approximate value. This starting line which is coinciding with this line. Okay, I am taking approximately 8 point. Okay, I am taking between 8 and 9. Now take this point, join this point to O and extend up to here like this. Okay, this is, let us take it is 8 point, not exactly 8.3 degrees, it may be 8.5 or 8.4, we don't know correctly. So measure this length, whatever length is here, I am giving this is 1 dash. Okay, it is not exactly 8.3. okay, remember that one. Just take this value, how much it is. This is the length of the first part. Okay, just let us take here 12 divisions are coming or not. This is the first division. Take this point as center, second division. This point as center, take the third division. Fourth part, fifth part, sixth part, seventh, eighth, 9, 10. So here we are getting 10 parts, but we need to divide into 12 equal divisions. So here we have to take less than this length. Okay, so I am using trial and error method. Listen carefully. So only 10 parts we got here. Okay, by using this length we have to take less than this. Okay, so I am taking trial and error method. Initially whatever this length is there, just do one line. Okay, mark this point is the starting point. So just mark this length. Okay, with this length here we are getting only 10 parts, so we have to take less than this. What I am taking, I will take this length instead of this length. I am taking less than this by using trial and error method. So measure this length, whatever length is there. Okay, less than this value. Okay, little gap is there. Here I am taking less value. Here what I am doing, I am removing these arcs. Okay, so remove the arcs neatly. Now I am taking the new length here. We don't know how much length it is, but less than the this initial value. By using compass I took the new length. So A is the starting point here, this A point. Just do first part, second part, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th. But 12th part is coming very less value. Okay, we need to reduce this length little more so that we will get the 12th part. What I am doing, so this is the first one, this is the second length. Now I am taking third length here, little less value. Okay, now remove these arcs again by using the eraser. Take the new length here. Third time we are trying to do this. Okay, take the new length. Center. Okay, A as center. Follow the same procedure. First one, second, and this is the third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10, 11, and this is the 12th. Now in the third length we will get the equal divisions here. Okay, this method is called trial and error method. We will get sometimes in 2 attempts, 3 attempts like that. 3 attempts means 3 different length we are taking within the limit. Limit means here instead of 8.3 we can't mark exactly. I am taking between 8 and 9 degrees one length. So here it is getting 12th part is coming here. So with this length we can't divide into 12 parts. I have reduced the length. second attempt it is. Next, third one. Okay, like that we have divided into equal divisions. One more method is also there for dividing equal divisions. Bisect this arc. Bisect this arc means divide this arc into two parts. Okay, here we have one video also how to bisect an arc. Bisect an arc means dividing this length into two equal divisions. Okay, so we will get one part and second part. After that, again we have to bisect this length of arc. Again we are bisecting this arc. Okay, like that we can divide into some equal number of parts. So here we got the parts, all parts. Now I am giving the intersection points 1 dash, this is this 2 dash, intersection points 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash, 8 dash, 9 dash, 10 dash, 11 dash, this B point is 12 dash. Here our main aim is we need to mark the centers C1, C2, C3 up to C12. For getting those centers, just join this center to one dash line and extend up to center arc by using the scale. So from this point to one dash here, you just do a line here and extend up to center arc. This intersection point is, I am marking C1. Okay. Now after that, join 2 dash to center and extend up to center arc. So this is C2. Now similarly, this center to 3 dash. Now this center to 4 dash. This line passing through 4, that's why it is C4. Next, center to 5. Next, center to 6. C6. Center to 7. C7. Center to 8. C8. Center to 9. Center to 10. Center to 11. And center to 12, C12. So these are all the 12 centers. Now after that, through center we did an arc. Similarly, here we have divided the circle into 12 parts. So from 1 also do an arc, 2 also do an arc like that. Take the same point as center by using the compass. Take O as center, 0, 1 first point is the radius, do an arc. Here 11 and 1 are passing through same center, this point and this point, because circle is symmetrical. Okay, just do an arc here up to this. Okay, remove the extra lines. Similarly, O as center, O2 as radius, do an arc. And 10 and 2 are passing through the same arc. Do up to this line. Similarly, from center we did. Next, 3. 3 and 9 are coming on the same arc. O3 is a radius. 9 and 3 are coming on the same arc. Okay. Next, O4. 4 and 8 both are coming on the same arc. Next, after 4, 5. For all the arcs, this is a center. Okay, O as a center. O5 and O7 both are coming on the same line. Next, last point is 6th one. O6 is a radius. Just two last arc. Okay. Now we did all arcs from all the points. After getting all the arcs, here if you are taking the example, this is a P point. Okay. So circle is moving from CV to C1. Okay, C1 to C2 like that. So next center is C1. Next center is C2 like that. Okay, next center is C3. But here if you are observing, this gap from center to this point is constant. Okay, now it is moving. Center to this point distance is constant. How much it is? 16 mm. It has given in the question. Let us assume this circle is rolling from C to C1. What is the CP distance? It is constant. It is 16 mm. Let us assume C1 is the center here. C1 center, P position from P to P1 it is coming here. Do an arc on the first line, first arc which is passing through 1. Okay, here Now mark that point P1, from P2 P1. So I am taking, this is P1. Now take from C1 to C2 center, do an arc on the second one which is passing through 2. Okay, take that intersection point to this arc and this arc, it is P2. Next take C3 center, do an arc on the third line, third curve. C3 center, do an arc on the third curve which is passing through 3. So this intersection point is P3. Okay, similarly from C3 to C4 center, do an arc on the fourth curve which is passing through 4. Mark this point is P4. Next after C4, center is C5. Okay, C5 center, do an arc on the fifth one which is passing through 5. The intersection point is P5. Next C6 center, after C5, C6 center, do an arc on the sixth one which is passing through 6th. Okay, this is P6. Next after 6, 7 center, C7 center, do an arc on the seventh one. 7 and 5 both are coming on this. Okay, C7 as center on this. So this is P7. After 7, take C8 as a center. 8th one, 8th line, 4 and 8, this line, okay, adjacent to 7, 8th line, do an arc here, P8. After 8, take C9 center, do an arc on the 9th line, okay, 9 and 3 are passing on this curve, okay, here it is. So this point is P9. Okay, after C9, take C10 center, do an arc on the 10th one, 10 and 2, both are coming on the same arc. Okay. So do here, this is P10. Okay, so after C10 center, C11. C11 center, do an arc on the 11th curve, this one. Now mark that point P11. After C11, take C12, do an arc on the 12th one. Okay, here also we have to do an arc. So similarly from all the points we did arc, okay, from center to P also we have to do an arc like this. Okay, now take CP distance. Okay, now after C11 take C12 as a center, from C12 to 12th line, 12th arc, so on it do point. It is exactly coming here at this point. This is P12. Now if you join all the P points from P2, P1, P2, P3 like that up to P12, we will get a curve. Okay, let us do join all the points by using freehand curve. Okay, so from P2, P1, initially do thin curve from P1 to P2. So P3 is here, P3 to P4, P4 to P5, P5 to P6, okay, P6 to P7. P7 to P8. P8 to P9 here. So P9 to P10, P10 to P11, P11 to P12, P11 to P12, like this. So we will get the curve like this. Make it dark. So this is the path of P point. This curve name is called epitrichoid. Here the given circle and this given path and required curve should be in dark color compared to the other lines. Okay, after that mark the given dimension. Here the given circle diameter is 50 mm, it has given here. Now you can take the parallel line here, we can mark the dimension here. Here there is no space, that's why I am taking this bigger diameter. I am keeping the diameter symbol here, 25 mm, and this CP length, P point is 16 mm from this. So here I am taking one of the radius. For radius mark capital R, 16. okay, no need to mark at all the points, just mark at one radius. Okay, after that the angle we have calculated, this is 100 degrees and this arc radius is this radius 90 mm. I have extended this an arc here, so I did one dimensional line by using scale like this. So I have marked R 90, it has given in the question, bigger arc radius. So this is the required, this is the procedure of doing this epitrochoid. If you like this lecture, hit the like button, subscribe my channel and share with your friends. The other cycloidal curves and then trochoids, I will give the link in description box, please check it. Thank you for watching.